Hi.
You there. We need to have a conversation.
You got my attention.
And you got my attention by poking your nose into my business. Specifically, by shooting up a place called Parsons State Insane Asylum.
Leave me alone!
Something's out there.
What just happened?
Take cover!
You'll find I'm very persistent.
You got my attention.
And you got my attention by poking your nose into my business. Specifically, by shooting up a place called Parsons State Insane Asylum. A place that happens to be owned by my boss.
What do you want from me exactly?
I took the trouble of tracking you down because I'm always looking for people that can handle themselves in dangerous situations. Seems like you may fit the bill.
What's the job?
I don't know yet. Whatever needs to be done once my boss has had a look at you. I can assure you that it will be dangerous, and that you'll be paid fairly.
I live for danger. Where do I sign up?
I like your enthusiasm. By the way, I'm Edward Deegan. You'll mostly be working for me, but you'll need to talk to my boss first. His name is Jack Cabot. He likes to personally interview everyone I hire. He's careful like that. Come down to Cabot House in Beacon Hill and ask to talk to Jack. I'll let him know you're coming.
Hey there.
Go and talk to Jack. Then we can get down to business.
I'm here to talk to Jack Cabot.
Oh, it's you. Good. Come on in.
Let's go meet the boss.
What is this place?
Better to let Jack answer that. Come on. Jack, the new guy is here.
One moment. I just have to.
He'll be right with us.
Oh, damn. Clearly, I'll need to adjust the mixture. Hello. Welcome to Cabot House. I'm Jack Cabot.
What is this place?
This is my ancestral home. The Cabots have always lived here, since long before the Great War. If you're asking what we're still doing here, with Boston in its current sad state, well, that's a story for another time, perhaps.
Just tell me what you need me to do.
All in good time. Consider this your final interview before getting the job. Please, have a seat. How about a drink? Edward, the good bourbon, eh? Please, have a seat. before we get down to business, I have a question I like to ask all my new employees.
Is this really the time
Don't interrupt, Edward. The question is this. Do you believe there is other intelligent life in the universe?
Are you talking about aliens? UFOs and little green men?
No, no. That's all popular hysteria. I doubt any of it has any basis in fact. I'm talking about the hidden history of our planet. The very origins of human civilization. Ancient powers that modern science, even at its pinnacle, could barely begin to comprehend.
That's really interesting.
This is all just smoke and mirrors and fictional nonsense. I thought you had a head on those shoulders.
I'm glad to hear you say that. It's become my life's work. My approach is to combine a rigorous scientific method while keeping an absolutely open mind. So much has been closed off to us simply because people assumed they already knew the answers. My father excavated a city in the Rub al-Khali in Arabia, which he dated to more than 4,000 years before the rise of any known human civilization. The structures and artifacts were strange, disturbing. Clearly not constructed for or by humans. I've spent my life trying to decipher what he uncovered.
Jack, can I tell him what I need him to do?
I'm sorry, Edward. I just get carried away sometimes. You're sending him to look for the missing shipment?
Yeah.
Well then, I'd better leave you to it. We'll talk more about this some other time, when things are less rushed. It isn't important now. Welcome to the family.
Okay, you're officially hired. Congratulations.
What was all that about?
Don't worry about it for now. That's part of the job, by the way. It's best to keep an open mind. Jack may be eccentric, but he's definitely not crazy. The job I got for you is simple. You know the old insane asylum you shot up? Parsons? There's an important package that went missing between there and here. I need you to track it down and bring it back to me. Any questions?
For starters, what's this package I'm looking for?
It's a metal case holding vials of serum. You don't need to worry about what it is. Jack needs it for his research. That's all you need to know. You should start at Parsons. We think the courier got ambushed as he was leaving the place. The guards heard gunfire in the distance, but we don't know exactly what happened. Check in with Maria at Parsons. She's in charge of the security force there. She can point you in the right direction. You all set then?
I have some questions.
Shoot.
Why does Jack have people guarding an old insane asylum?
I don't mind you asking questions. As long as you don't mind me not answering them. If it was important to what I was asking you to do, I'd tell you. In this case, it isn't. Anything else?
How did this package go missing?
The courier got there and picked up the package just fine, but never got back here. Could be simple bad luck, or it could be a deliberate ambush. That's why I'm sending you. It's important that you recover the missing package. You all set then?
Nothing else.
Okay. They're expecting you over at Parsons, so you'd better get going.
Ah, hello. Ah, you're back. Do you need something?
What's going on at that old insane asylum?
I carry out some of my research there. That's all you need to know.
The more I know, the better I'll be at my job.
Well, I suppose that may be true. My father is confined in Parsons. For his own safety and everyone else's. He became dangerously unstable after handling an ancient artifact he found in Arabia. I've spent my life trying to figure out how to cure him. Are we done?
How'd your father manage to travel to Arabia with the world blown to hell?
Ah, well, that was before the war, when he was a young man.
How's that possible? The war was 200 years ago.
One of the effects of my father's illness was a slowing or arresting of the aging process. So, yes, he is well over 200 years old, as you suspected. Are we done?
I was intrigued by your theory about an ancient alien civilization.
Actually, it was my father's theory. Now proven beyond doubt, although only to me, unfortunately. There aren't many archaeology journals publishing these days.
You have proof.
Enough to satisfy me. Because of his illness, my father could not, or would not, explain exactly where he found the lost city. So I've had to confine my studies to what he brought back from his first expedition. But that's been enough to show beyond a doubt that the city he found wasn't made by or for human beings. Millennia older than the earliest human civilizations, but with technology that seems to have surpassed our own. And yet, everything about it is strange, disturbing geometries, tools not made for human hands, carvings that hint at dimensions beyond our own.
What was your father's theory?
He believed that all of the earliest human civilizations shared some common parent that was unknown to history. Think of Atlantis. The myth of an advanced civilization destroyed by a cataclysm is shared by many widely separated ancient cultures. Eventually, he found what he was looking for. A lost city, buried beneath the sands of the empty quarter of the Arabian desert.
You said your father found a lost city?
Yes. He spent years looking, and was widely ridiculed by the so-called experts. I'm ashamed to say even I doubted him. But in the end, he found it. A lost city, buried in the sands of the Rub al-Khali, the empty quarter of Arabia.
I wanted to ask you about something else.
All right.
Quite a place you've got here. Amazing that it survived the war.
Thank you. I try not to take it for granted. We were definitely more fortunate than most. It hasn't been easy keeping it up to pre-war standards, but we do what we can. Are we done?
I've got to get going.
All right.
This place is off limits. You'd best move along.
Edward Deegan sent me. I'm looking for a missing package.
Oh, you're the new guy. So this package... pretty sure we know where it is. The guys that shot Ben are holed up in the Parsons Creamery, just north of here.
Who are these guys? Raiders?
Sure. Assholes with guns. Though it's weird that they're still hanging around so close. Kinda like they're scouting this place or something. I don't like it. I'm glad you're gonna finally get rid of them.
I'd be happy to send someone to look for her, ma'am. It's not a...
Mother, Edward has better things to do than sending someone out to find Imogene. Again.
I can't believe you don't care what happens to your sister.
I'm not going to have Edward drop everything just because Imogene decided to take a lover again.
Jack, how dare you speak so disrespectfully about your sister?
Hey, Edward.
So did you find out what happened to the courier?
It's been over this, Mother.
I don't think you're even listening to me, Jack.
If she wanted us to know where she went, she would have told someone.
Some raiders set up camp near Parsons and ambushed him. I took care of them.
I don't like raiders operating so close to Parsons. I hope this isn't the start of something serious. What about the serum he was carrying? Did you get any of it back?
If your father were here, he'd send someone to find Imogene.
There was only this one vial left.
Oh, good. I was afraid we wouldn't get any of it back. Here's your pay for the job. I'm throwing in a little bonus for bringing back the serum. That was good work. Now, as far as what's next... Oh, hell, I guess it's time you met Wilhelmina. Jack's not gonna be happy about it. Come on.
I can't believe you don't care what happens to your sister.
She's a grown woman.
Jack, I'll take care of it. Mrs. Cabot, don't worry. I'll send someone to find Imogene.
Thank you, Edward. I can always count on you. Why can't you be as devoted as dear Edward?
You shouldn't indulge her, Edward. It just makes her more impossible to deal with next time.
Just doing my job. Speaking of which, here's all we got back of the last delivery from Parsons. Raiders got the rest of it, I'm sorry to say.
Ah, good. Finally. This will help settle Mother down.
Imogene is Jack's sister. You probably figured that out yourself. She's, a little flighty. Impulsive. From time to time, she runs off. Usually with a new boyfriend. Then I send somebody to bring her home.
Do you know where she's gone?
No, but it shouldn't be too hard to find out. She's been spending a lot of time in Good Neighbor. That's a jazz club there, the third rail. Somebody there must know something. She's not known for keeping her mouth shut.
What if she doesn't want to come home?
Obviously, as one of the family, you can't just knock her in the head and drag her home by her heels. Usually, by the time I send someone after her, she's gotten bored with the whole thing and is ready to come home. I'm sure you'll think of something. You're supposed to be resourceful, remember? Jack says there's no hurry about finding Imogene, but he doesn't mean it. Now you've met the matriarch of the family. Explains a lot, doesn't it?
Why does Imogene do this to me? I just can't bear to think what might have happened to poor Imogene. I can't believe how callous Jack can be about his sister.
Hey. Yes. Sweet hip boy, brother. You hold on to that.
My client appreciates the work you did with his rat problem. Now, if you're buying, let's hear what you want.
Yeah. Do you know Imogene Cabot?
Name rings a bell. Kind of balmy. Haven't seen her in a while, though. Try Magnolia. She likes to make friends with people. She might know more about this missing bird. Magnolia! This guy wants a word!
You're looking for me? What can I do for you?
Do you know Imogene Cabot?
Imogene? Sure. I know her. I haven't seen her in a while, though. Are you a friend of hers?
I just need to talk to her.
Why are you looking for her, honey?
Her family's worried that something's happened to her.
Well, I'm glad somebody's looking out for her. She seems like a body that could use looking after.
Do you know where she's gone?
There was this preacher fella who used to come in here all the time. One of the slick ones. Always going on about remaking your life and so on. Most of the customers wouldn't give him the time of day, but Imogene, she latched on to him for some reason. I don't suppose it hurt that he was easy on the eyes. Intense. Some women find that irresistible.
Pam, would you come over here a minute?
Is there a problem, Miss Magnolia?
No, this fine gentleman here was just looking for Imogene. Do you happen to know where that preacher fella came from?
Brother Thomas?
Yes, that's right. The one Imogene was always hanging on.
Had to throw him out. Wouldn't stop bothering customers with that salvation racket. Kept going on and on about joining him at the back bay. Then he'd shove those stupid flyers in your face. Here, I kept one of them, just in case he didn't pay his bar tab.
Well, thanks, honey. You were a big help.
Anything for you, miss.
I hope Imogene's all right. I didn't much like the idea of her going off with that preacher fella. Something I can do for you, handsome?
Nothing. I'll leave you to it.
Oh, okay.
Welcome, neighbor. We're always glad to see a new face around here. Step right this way, and I'll be happy to tell you all about our movement and how you can be a part of it.
I'm looking for Imogene Cabot.
Oh, I'm sorry, but Imogene is indisposed right now. She's not seeing visitors.
I just need to make sure she's okay.
You've got my word. She's fine. She's just staying in her room right now. Not that it's any of your business, but she and I are just having a little relationship trouble. You know how it is. She's not seeing anybody until she cools off.
I killed the last guy who was running this scam, in case that matters to you.
One way or another, we're going to see her.
Good to know. Let me just unlock the door for you, okay?
That's right. I'm here to rescue you.
What makes you think I need to be rescued?
Watch it. They've gone dark.
You're Jack's sister? I was expecting someone a bit younger.
You really know how to flatter a lady, don't you?
Hostiles have retreated.
Just to be clear, I'm Jack's younger sister, the baby of the family. Once I get home and get some of Jack's serum, I'll be back to my usual stunning self.
Jack has a serum that reverses aging?
It's more like it halts aging. I started taking it when I was 32, so normally that's what I look like. You'll see once I get my treatment. I was well known as one of the belles of Boston society, back when there was any.
What happens if you don't get more serum?
Oh, I don't think we need to worry about that. I've gone without a treatment much longer before, with no lasting effect.
Actually, there's only one vial of the serum left. Raiders got the rest.
I'd better get home before Mother convinces Jack that she needs all of it. That he could still be such a mama's boy at his age is ridiculous. I'm so disappointed in Thomas. He seemed so interesting at first. But after we came here, he turned out to be just another brute. He actually thought it could force me to join his absurd cult.
Your boyfriend Thomas was a real charmer.
I was done with him, and he shouldn't have locked me in here. Oh, I'm not going with you. You can tell Mother I'll be along home before too long. I just need a drink first.
Thank you.
switch over to the Hartley modulator. Do you copy?
See now. How's this?
Oh, that's done it. Edward, what's going on there?
We're under attack. They're inside the building.
Inside? Can you keep them out of the basement?
I'm trying, Jack. I've never seen raiders.
They're inside the building. You have to go to the office and shut down the elevator. You can't risk them getting to Lorenzo.
Got it. Office. Elevator. You better round up whoever you can and get them.
Hello? Edward? Come in. Edward! There's no signal at all. I've lost him.
What's happening, Jack? If these people are inside Parsons, if they free him...
Don't worry, I'll handle it.
I always knew it would end this way. I never should have allowed you to lock up Lorenzo in that place.
That isn't helping, Mother. And as I recall, using the serum was your idea, not mine.
So what are you going to do?
I said I'll handle it. I'm thinking.
Who are you again?
What's going on?
That was Edward. He's at Parsons, the old asylum. They're under attack by raiders. It's strange. The guards have held off raiders before without any trouble. I don't know what's gone wrong this time.
I found Imogene. She's fine.
Oh, yes. Good.
At least one small comfort on this terrible day.
You'll be wanting to be paid, of course. Edward usually handles these things. Caps is what you use for currency, isn't that right? Here. I hope that's the right amount. Now, we really need to focus on the current emergency.
How can you be so callous about your sister's safety?
I wonder if these could be the same raiders that stole that last shipment. If some of them had used the undiluted serum, it could explain their unusual success against Edward's men.
What exactly does this serum do?
I suppose it's time you knew. The main benefit of the serum is to halt aging. My family and I are all over 400 years old, but it also confers other side effects. Especially in the undiluted form that the raiders stole. It increases strength and resistance to all kinds of physical damage. So at least some of these raiders may be much more dangerous than the ones you're used to dealing with.
Where do you get this serum from?
As you probably guessed, my father is the source of the serum.
Jack, are you sure it's wise telling him all this?
In the course of my attempts to cure him, I discovered that the artifact had introduced... anomalies into his blood. So the source of his insanity is also the basis of the treatments that have prolonged all our lives. The irony isn't lost on me, but if he were to escape from Parsons, I would lose my father forever. I will not allow that to happen. Not to mention that the artifact has made him paranoid, homicidally violent, and endowed with extraordinary abilities.
Exactly what abilities does he have?
Enhanced strength, unusual resistance to most kinds of physical damage. Oh, and a kind of local telekinesis, which appears to be projected by the artifact itself. That's why I've built a dampening field into his cell. Which is why we really need to stop these intruders before they turn it off. Before we go, I need you to understand something. When we get to Parsons, you need to do exactly what I tell you. Nothing more, nothing less. Is that clear?
Why is that so important?
If these intruders have gotten past Edward's men, they may have freed Lorenzo. I'm the only one who understands exactly how to deal with him. Is that clear enough for you?
Got it.
Good. Make sure you have whatever you'll need for a serious battle. I'll wait for you outside.
Jack, be careful. And try not to hurt him.
I love Father at least as much as you do. But you know as well as I do that if he gets free, there will only be one option.
Don't let it come to that, please.
I'll do my best, Mother. And if Imogene finally comes home, for God's sake, don't let her leave again until I get back. Now I really do have to go.
Oh. What do you want?
Excuse me.
I don't need anything right now, thank you.
Ready? Let's go. Just to be clear, under no circumstances can we allow Lorenzo to be freed from Parsons. I would have lost my father forever. I refuse to let that happen after spending so long trying to cure him. Seem to have given a good account of themselves, but not good enough, sadly.
Excuse me.
We need to get to Parsons. Okay, stick close, follow my orders, and I'm sure everything will be fine. Let's go.
Side.
Wait, listen. Lefties, right. Get ready.
Where that juice is coming from?
Hell yeah.
How'd you get any of it anyway? Lefty doesn't even like you. I cashed in some favors with people who Lefty does like. We just saw it. Got a taste.
You better be right. And Lefty better share it out fair, or it's not just me. It's
using the elevator?
Yeah.
I sent the elevator down to the basement like you wanted and shut it down.
Good.
Shot quite a few of them before they decided to leave me alone in here. Haven't seen anybody for quite a while. I think it's hard to keep track of time.
Are you sure you can't get up? I could really use your help.
Yeah, Jack. I'm pretty damn sure.
Well, then don't worry about it. Me and your friend here will have to take care of things ourselves. They've definitely reached the basement. Although I don't understand how they knew how to get past it. It doesn't matter now. We'll have to go through the abandoned part of the building. It looks like the Abremelin field is still functioning. Although several of the security doors in the basement have already been breached. We'd better hurry if we want to stop them. They seem determined to reach Lorenzo for some reason.
Hell yeah. What exactly is going on here?
I suppose it's time you knew. It's hard to overstate exactly how dangerous the artifact has made Lorenzo. In addition to being homicidally psychotic, he has also gained enhanced strength. An unusual resistance to most kinds of physical damage. He also commands a kind of local telekinesis, which appears to be projected by the artifact itself. Now, we need to get to the basement before these intruders find a way to set Lorenzo free. Follow me.
Be careful, Jack.
There.
Telling what we'll run into. A mess. Let's hope we can find a way through. The utility elevator is on the bottom floor. Come on.
Thank you.
Heads up.
A smart soldier is always prepared.
Old utility elevator is still working. This will take us to the basement. Come on, this is the only way down.
Going down.
Get in there and stop them.
Hello, Jack. It's been a long time since I've had the pleasure of a personal visit.
Father, I will stop this.
My powers have grown, Jack. The artifact still has so much to teach me. Once I am free, I will be happy to teach you too.
No, I can't let you out until I can remove the artifact. See? Balls! They've locked down all the security doors. I'll have to open them one by one from here while you work your way down the hallway. Quickly now!
I need to shut down the container.
containment in order to open the door. Our men upstairs don't seem to have been of much use.
The irrelevancy of this town!
Apparently, even the simplest task was beyond
There's still one chance. I just need a moment to enter the failsafe comms. It's not too late. It will take some time for him to regain his power.
Don't listen to my son. He's the crazy one. You know this. Look at what he's done to me.
I built a failsafe to the containment bridge. Switched the core of Revelant Generator to tank for override. And I turned on his challenge.
Do the right thing. Open this door and let me out. Do the right thing. Out of here. Please, just open the door. Everything my son has told you about me is a self-serving lie. That must be obvious now. Think back on everything Jack has told you. Who do you think is great? Everything my son has told you about me is a self-serving lie. That must be obvious now. Do the right thing and be out of here. Think back on everything Jack has told me. Crazy.
That's it! Don't worry, the Zeta radiation won't harm you. I'm sorry, Father. I did everything I could to avoid this. I believe I was close to finding a way to remove the artifact.
Liar! Depend upon me here forever if you've had your way, puny worm. Do you truly think you have the power to destroy me?
Goodbye, Father. We didn't have any other choice, did we?
What would he have done if he'd gotten free?
Oh, he would have killed both of us, and then the rest of my family. And that would only have been the beginning. His crimes, back when he was free. It was only because of my family's influence that he ended up here, rather than on death row. The world now, it's a world made for monsters. Nothing could have stopped him. No. I've answered my own question. We truly had no choice.
What now?
I need to bury my father and shut down this place. I won't be back here again. Before you go, I couldn't have done this without your help. I think this is fair compensation. I won't be needing your services after this.
You don't need me anymore.
more.
No. Without Parsons to run, I don't think I'll need such an extensive staff.
Saving your family's gotta be worth more than that.
You know, I was so close to understanding the artifact. Now that I can study it directly, I may be able to do something useful with it. Come back and see me at Cabot House in a week or so. All my research may not have been completely in vain. I only wish I'd been able to find some way to cure my father before it came to me. Yes, I just need a little more time. I might have found some.